The light is very bright here, and I don't know if this is registering correctly, but I live near Drancy, France. It's like two towns over, kind of. And the old deportation camp for France was there, and it was mostly children who were shipped out. And I must point out that the Nazis did not ask for children to be delivered. And the French at that time, much to their eternal shame, fetched those kids right up. And I don't think any of them survived, really. I've never heard of a child survivor of Drancy. This is part of the Shoah thing here in France, which is very big. France is extremely anti-Semitic, and there are very, very few practicing Jews here in France, and most are in Strasbourg, I believe. I think that there are, I would say, less than 300,000 practicing Jews still in France. And it's very shameful. And I still find evidence of anti-Semitism here, and it bothers me a great deal. I think that this might be one of those sad things that you might want to visit if you visit Paris, because it's just over the city limits of Paris, really. You know, it's kind of like the Picpus Cemetery at in the 12th arrondissement, where they have these mass graves, and mostly ordinary people died during the first French Revolution in the 18th century. There was more than one French Revolution, by the way. There were, like, I think three more in the 19th century. And it was very sad. Very, very sad. And the first French Revolution was an abject failure. Most of the dead were ordinary people, and then clergy, and religion was banned during the terror. And third on the list were aristocrats. So this is very sad, but you might want to look this up and possibly visit it, but likely you can see it online. It's really terrible. I never feel comfortable when I go to Drancy. I don't really know what to say about living here in this country, having such a burden on us and other burdens also. But I'm American, so I guess I know about burdens. You know, I suppose we all do. Okay, bye.